Welcome. We have here with us Yara Gunn, who is a TV host for different programs in Pakistan. He's also one of the best rappers in Pakistan, and his style of music has produced a lot of successful and popular hits. Welcome, and thank you for being with us.
Well, thank you so much for having me on your show and bearing with me.
How did you become involved with the tour, with the World Tour 1997?
Well, I signed up for the World Tour 1997 back in 1995. And then it was supposed to be World Tour 1995. But due to some other reasons, you know, the tour got delayed and everything and all that. And I got started up with a film as well and all that. So things happened, and so the 95 tour turned out to be a 97 tour. And trust me, this tour has been going on for 3 years. So it's not exactly the 1997 World Tour. It's the 1995, 96, 97 World Tour. And I hope it doesn't go into 1998.
How would you define your music? I mean, you're a rapper, but how?
Well, I'm not actually the rapper. You know, the one with the attitude, yo, don't mess with me because I'll kick your duh. It just happened that at the time when I debuted in Pakistan and I realized that nobody else was doing rap music in Pakistan, and that I thought that was one form of music that was missing from Pakistan. So I just got up and I said, okay, I want to do music, and I do a rap song. I recorded one song on the studio, and that was my first ever experience in the studio. I did the song and took it out and tossed it around to my friends, because I just did it for fun. I didn't know I was going to end up doing all this. And my friend said, hey, this is good, you should do this. I mean, like, nobody else is doing it, so why don't you do it? So I ended up doing a whole album, and then the album, and I took the album to the EMI people back in Pakistan, and I just put the album on the table. The next thing I knew, they had a 3-year contract for me. And so things just took off for me from there onwards.
What has been the response from the public in Pakistan and around the world of this new form of music?
Well, because I fused Bhangra and rap music at a time when in Pakistan, rap music wasn't, like, people hardly knew what rap was all about. And the response at that time was massive. Let me just summarize the whole story for you. November 93, I launched my first album called Wrap Up, and that has a song Bhangra Rap in it. February the 1st, my song goes on air on video, on television. Mm-hmm. Now, it goes on air on the first week of February, and the second week of February, it is at number 2 on the charts. In the third week of February, I'm called in as a guest on that very show, that the chart show that we have in Pakistan, Music Channel Charts. And I was at number 1 that week, third week, and I was there for an interview. And the producer ended up offering me the job of the VJ. He said, hey, do you want to be a VJ? And I said, are you sure? And he said, yeah. And I said, okay, fine. So I ended up being a VJ. Now, here I am, a VJ, got my song at blah, 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 blah. It stayed on charts for about, I don't know how many weeks. I was lucky, thank God. And thanks to all the people who just accepted the song and everything. Signed up with Pepsi that very July. Kept on doing my first show. Then Pepsi came up with a second contract for me to host their show called Pepsi Top of the Pops. So I left my first show, went doing Pepsi Top of the Pops. Did my second album, came out, stayed on the charts for like God knows how long.
Your second album was No More School.
No More School remixes. That had about 3 songs, new songs in it, and the rest of them were the old songs with remixes. And surprisingly, the remixes did better than the first album. I ended up selling more copies of the first album on the remixes than the first album. But I don't know how that happened.
Which has been your latest album?
The last one I did was Lotau. That was released last year in January. And it had a video for the title track Lotau, which was Pakistan's highest budgeted video ever shot, ever made. It was, of course, financed by my sponsors, Pepsi Cola. And it was the highest budgeted video. It ran on MTV. By the way, I was the first Pakistani artist who went out on MTV Asia. And then we had other artists going on in MTV Asia as well. And all of a sudden, the Asian market started opening for us. Once I had gone on to MTV Asia, and then other bands started following in and all that. And then we were looking at a broader market and all like that. But Lotto was my last album, and that had less rap in it and more my sort of music. And that is contemporary pop that has a lot of guitars in it and a lot of fusion of R&B and classical music and all that. So, I mean, like, ugh.
Can you sing for us a little bit of your latest album, of What other songs?
I tell you what, I'll sing off the album. I'm also doing an English album now in the UK. I'm recording an international release. I've signed up with a British recording company. And so might as well just sing you guys something off that album. What do you say?
That's fine with me.
Yeah?
Do you know the name of this album that's going to come
out? We haven't named the album as yet. I mean, we've just recorded two songs. I have about like 10 songs on it, and it's a very controversial album, mind you, because from an Asian, people do not accept topics like the topics that I am touching on the album. Like, there's a song about AIDS, where I'm trying to make people aware of AIDS, not exactly about AIDS, but precautions, and telling them, which is blatantly in-your-face lyrics. I mean, it goes like, "Don't forget to use the rubber!" I mean, it's like being very straightforward. So that's going to be a very controversial album from an Asian guy. And that's the sort of stuff I'm really into. And it does make statements like a song called "Cops Are Coming For Me," and which is about racial discrimination against people, not just Asians, not just black people, but against all different kinds of color and creed by the police anywhere in the world. And so it's a very controversial album.
To give a message to your fans?
I'm trying to hit out there, make a statement. Okay, I don't care if that album becomes a hit or not. I don't care if it sells or not. That is not my aim. My aim is to make sure that people out there get to know about things. And I mean, hey, what? I got really crazy songs in there, so I like it.
Can you sing for us one that might not be so crazy, but your favorite song?
My favorite song. Okay. This one is called "I Don't Want to Know Your Name, I Just Want to Make Love." Can I sing that on TV?
You can sing that one, I think.
This is a slow one. "I don't want to know your name, I just want to make love. Oh, I don't want to know your name, I just want to make love."
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Now, what is your future projects include? The new album in English. Now, what movie projects do you have? Do you have any movie projects?
Yeah, I also signed up for a Pakistani big screen film. Sorry, I was going to say television program. I've done so many television shows. I signed up for a Pakistani movie about a year and a half ago. My producers told me the movie's going to finish in 3 months, and it's been going on and on and on, and it's not. It still hasn't finished. It's a joint venture between India and Pakistan. I'm the hero in the movie. We've shot the entire film on the beautiful island of Mauritius, and it was absolutely beautiful. The entire technical crew and staff is all from Bollywood, from Bombay, now called Mumbai, India, and the cast is from Pakistan, the story is from Pakistan, music, everything done from Pakistan, the art side was taken care of from Pakistan. A lovely movie. I still have to go back home. My producers have been expecting me for the last 3 months, but I've been on the run, on the road, to finish the movie now. But as soon as I get the time, I would go back there.
What is the name of the movie?
It's called Very Good Dunya, Very Bad Log. That means very good world, very bad people.
Do you sing in this movie?
No, I'm not singing in the movie. I just cannot sing Pakistani film music. It is depressing. I did not say that, but it's on record, so I don't care. Well.
You have hosted and you still host TV programs. Are you trying to combine all three movie programs?
Oh yes, I mean, I'm trying to combine, and it's a nightmare. It's a nightmare on my street, you know. I have about 175 shows as a VJ back in Pakistan. I've done about 175 shows. That means I was on TV for 175 weeks straight. And doing a movie, but I'm not going to get into another movie, because they come and they tell you, hey, it's going to take only 3 months, and it ends up taking almost 2 years. So I'm not going to get involved in another movie. I will be directing a movie next year, definitely.
When you get on stage and you get the response that you're having on your American tour, how do you feel? What are the feelings that go on while you're on stage?
Oh, it is so good. It comes and kicks you right there. You know, you feel like, okay, people are ready to rock and roll. that sort of thing, you know, it's like fun. It is really fun. It's a delight, you know. You ought to be on the concert. Sorry, I've been trying to convince this lady here to come to the concert, and she just wouldn't agree to come to the concert. Trust me, we're not that bad. I swear to God. People think we're coming down from the third world country, right? That we probably have third world rock or pop. Hey, it is good pop music. Please do come down. I mean, I'd like to have someone so pretty like yourself sitting right in the first row. I've been trying to flirt with her as well.
I would.
Just kidding.
Now, let me ask you another question. Yeah. For Pakistan, rap music must be a new thing. What has been the public response to this? I mean, have you got any criticisms?
Oh, I got a lot of criticism. I got a lot of criticism from people who listen to classical music in Pakistan. Now, what happens is, everyone in pop music in Pakistan gets a lot of criticism from people who listen to classical music, because they say, hey, what the hell are you doing to music? But what the heck, you gotta learn to take criticism. It is okay. It is perfectly fine. But people have been very supportive. They think that it was experimental. But what I've done now, this time around, I also have my fourth Pakistani album ready to release in June when I go back. I finish a couple of videos and release it. That does not have a single rap song on it. So it's like, in your face, critics.
So you're trying, you're doing also some things that may not include rap music.
Yeah, because rap really, as I said, I did it at that time when nobody else was doing it. Been there, done that, got the t-shirt, I'm out of there.
So you're not going to make any more movies?
I will direct movies next. Next year I'm directing a film.
You're directing a film.
I'm going to direct a movie. I'm writing the script myself, and I have the finances lined up, the producers lined up. I will be directing that movie myself.
What is your goal in 10 years?
Well, in 10 years' time, my goal is to, well, get some sort of international acclaim where my music is concerned. Also, to serve the better purpose of humanity in my own eccentric ways, which offends a lot of people. But hey, you know, not everyone likes to hear the truth. And I like to support truth, no matter what it is. It could be bad for my people, it could be bad for somebody else, but as long as it's the truth, I support that, and I will support that in the coming 10 years, 20 years, or for the rest of my life. That's because I don't want to be a politician.